everybody, Joe Costello out in the pits of the NHRA. You know I'm looking for cool cars, right? I found one that's pretty unique. Nick Scardelli's, what is it? Not a Mustang, it's a Mercury Capri. Nick, tell me about your car.
So it's a 85 Mercury Capri. A lot of times confused with a Mustang for sure. You don't really see much, many of them out here. But it's a unique car in combo, and it's been running well for us, so.
How many people come up to you and make that mistake? I think the first time I saw it, I might have made that mistake as well. But it's very unique. It's got some very unique body lines in the areas that matter.
For sure, yeah. I mean, the first thing is everybody likes how we kept the bubble back. I know there's the two styles, and the bubble back kind of differentiates it between the Mustang, and we like it. It's unique, and you know, like I said, it's running well for us, and it's fun to drive too. So,
how long have you had the car?
So we've had it since about 2008. We're kind of building it. We got it from a good friend of ours, John Pressing. He had it laying around there. It was looking rough at the time, but we had a really good time putting it together. My dad did almost all the work, but it came out really well, and we're really happy with it.
He does the work, you do the driving?
Yeah, luckily, yes. Yes, I'm very lucky to have that opportunity. So. Yeah.
All right, but the paint job is what, to me, pops. Yes. All kinds of candy reds and white and blue and pink and yellow and orange, and like you got everything in there, and if I told somebody that, they might not think it works. It works in a big way. How'd you come up with this scheme?
It is loud, but you know, my dad's kind of had a bunch of paint jobs on his Ford Probe. He's been a Ford guy all his life, so we wanted to do something that kind of jumped out at you. And probably when I was a little bit younger, I was a little more excited about it too, so I wanted something out there. And Circus, Jesse Lejeune over at Circus, you know, he's a master, and he created it for us. So.
Yeah. Well, it's beautiful. How old is this paint job? Because I think I've seen it for a few years, and it's holding up tremendous.
Yes, and it's been through a few things too, but it's around, what, 2009, 2010-ish?
15 years.
Yeah, and we try to keep it, obviously, in good condition, but... obviously, when you're out here running as fast as you can and as many laps as you can, it takes its beating. So
absolutely. It's a race car after all, but it is also a car show. Can we see under the hood?
Absolutely.
Yeah, everybody checking out the Mercury Capri. The whole grille is very different. The taillights are very unique. Mercury went away, just like Pontiac. My brand went away. It's very disturbing and upsetting, but beautiful under the hood as well. Nick, tell us what we're looking at.
Thank you. So this is the 68... Mercury Cougar combination. So that's when it came out. It's the rated 230 from the factory, also 230 by NHRA. They allow us in for this engine to run aftermarket heads, which we are running here. But yeah, that's C4 transmission. Yeah, that's pretty much it.
Yeah, but meticulous attention to detail, and I see that a lot has been done to stiffen super stockers. People don't realize, but there's a lot done to stiffen these cars.
For sure. I mean, from the suspension to the rear, you know, it looks like it's supposed to be from the factory, but you know, there's little things that you could do to squeeze out some extra ET, and that's what we try to do.
Can we see you in the car?
Yeah, sure.
Climb in there. And guys, I don't know if you can come right here and shoot across. The candy apple paint is shining in the sun. It is absolutely beautiful. Nick is going to climb in, checking out the bubble rear window. Don't fire it up yet, Nick. Don't fire it up, right? I want to talk to you about this interior, because the just amazing insanity of attention to detail continues with the interior.
Yeah, so obviously the paint was out there, so we wanted to continue it inside. Obviously, it's the stock dash that came in the Mercury Capri for that year, but with some of the other upholstery items, we tried to keep it as clean as possible. I know a lot of people say, why'd you go with the light? It's going to get dirty, but we try to keep it clean and stayed pretty good over the last, you know, 15 years, like I said, yeah.
All right, walk us through a run in this car before you fire it up.
Sure, so you fire it up, make sure that, you know, the fan's on, water pump's on. You go through your burnout, you go from one all the way to three for what I do. You know, make sure you're getting the tires as hot as you can, without going too overboard and getting the engine too hot. And then you get up to the line, take a deep breath, and you try to bump in shallow as possible so you could be as consistent as you can be each run. Then once the lights are coming down, you make sure you have your trans brake button down and on. You jam the throttle and you let go and you hold on. You try to have some fun, because that's my favorite part of being in here is the wheel stands. So
yeah, big wheel stand on this car.
We try. That's why, you know, you get that adrenaline only in one place, and that's sitting here. So
amazing. Can we hear it run?
Yeah, absolutely.
Fire it up. Here we go. Nick Scardelli, Mercury Capri. Looks good, sounds good, and oh, by the way, I think it's pretty quick. What's your best ETN speed?
So we were 991 in really good air in ACCO. ACCO Jagway recently closed, but 991 at about 133.
That is tremendous, as indicated by his little buddy on the passenger side. Who you got riding with you there? Grab him.
Yep. We're lucky enough to be class winners this weekend, GTL automatic, so had a good weekend so far. Hopefully we could keep it going in eliminations tomorrow. So.
Well, good luck, and thank you for sharing your car with us, Nick.
Absolutely. Have a good one. Thanks.
There it is. He's a beautiful car. It's a fast car. It's a clean car. He's racing with his dad. What's cooler than that? That's why you come out into the pits here at the NHRA.